Hello everybody and welcome back to the Immortal Elven Colony here on RimWorld 1.0. In the last episode, we sent out a diplomatic mission that was brokering peace between two different factions, the High Council of the Elves, which we are now the ally of, and the Purple Squirrel Kai. So we actually had a very, very big success, and we gained relations with both factions, of course, having the High Council of the Elves as our ally now, which is pretty cool. So they'll actually help us out if we get raided. They might send a little force to come and help us defeat that raid. So that's actually pretty cool. So we'll actually see if that actually happens if we get raided again. So Sindiri and Glavratus are on the way back. They're really, really close to being back at home. We also have a bulk goods trader that's coming in from the Shire. So once they get over here, once Sindiri gets back, we'll trade with them and see if we can buy some... What do we need? We needed something. I mean, we have a lot of silver. We have like 2,000 here, but we have another 2,000 on our little caravan, so that we have a lot of silver to actually trade goods back and forth. I think I need some more steel. No, we have a lot up here. I don't know. We'll see. We'll just see. We actually need this dining room done this episode. It's taking a very, very long time for this to get done, but we do have an engaged couple that needs to get married. Now, I'm not sure if they're waiting exactly for a designated spot, but I would rather have that designated spot in this room. It'll be a much beautiful place for them to have their ceremony. All right. Animal starvation. Not again. What is wrong with you? There is food all over the place. You're not stuck anywhere. You have all of that to graze. I think these pigs are just dumb. I really, really do. That's just getting frustrating. You can go up here now. Do whatever you want, okay? Eat to your heart's content. Just stay out of the food storage, all right? Wandering. Are you not gonna eat? Oh, for the love of... Whatever. They can die if they want to. I'm done with the pigs. The pigs... It's not going to be a reliable source of food anyway. It takes a while for them to grow. So it's going to be a kind of... I don't think it's worth it. I'd rather have, like, cows, because they at least provide milk over time. And then you could slaughter them if their population grows out of control kind of thing. But pigs only provide one thing, and that's pork. So it's not really that big of a deal. Okay. You know what? I'm actually going to chop down this tree right here. It doesn't look good here because of the fact that it kind of overlaps the inside. So I'm just going to chop it down. Alright, so it looks like the caravan has arrived back home. Sindirian and Glavratus are coming back, not even riding the, Oh, no. Don't melee attack. Ride them back home. No! What is wrong with you? Come on! I shouldn't have to manually do that. Okay, and just before you go to bed, Sindirian, I want you to trade with Hannah. All right, let's see. So, we can't actually sell the pigs. That would have been perfect. I'm not buying your Yorkshire Terriers. Yorkshire Terriers are the most useless animal in this game. I hate them because they don't do anything. You can't train them it's so bad. All right, food, components. We have a lot of components. Steel, we probably could use some more steel. Pipeweed, we could sell that. We do, of course, have a lot more stuff in our inventory, but it's not showing up here. Foxford, blah, blah, blah. We could sell the beds for more silver, but I think we're okay with that. Could buy some elf armor. That would be pretty nice. Could buy some coal chunks as well. You know what? I'm going to leave this until morning, once we get actually everything off of our caravan. And then we'll see where to go from there. So I'll buy what I have, and that'll be it. Okay, why don't you haul back wherever... Where's the armor? Right there. So hopefully tomorrow morning they finish up these mines. Then we can go ahead and start hauling everything out of here. And then... Oh! Dangerous temperature! It's only 5 degrees. Come on, it's not even below zero. You can... Damn it. We didn't even get to talk to Dora. Dora, who gives quests. Because she's... an adventurer. Okay. Dora the Adventurer. Perfect. Oh, they had a warg, too. They're just taunting me. They came in... Oh, you know what? No. We're not going to catch up to the leader. Well, fine. Be that way. Goodbye. Peace talks. Again? Serino, Warlord of the Spoilers Desert, has sent us a message. She wants to talk with us in a nearby location. It will be a great opportunity to improve relations with their faction and receive gifts. Oh, okay, so this is just one faction who is at negative 99. Even if we go here and it's a success, it's not going to come up to the point where they're not hostile anymore. I mean, it's probably still worth it. So, and that is right there. 1.5 days, 3.3 to get back. It's tempting. It's very tempting. Let's see what happens today, and then we'll go from there. Asau is pregnant. Yeah, but you're dying of malnutrition, so it's not really... You have hypothermia, too? I didn't think animals could get... Oh, God. All right, you know what? The pigs, they're done. Absolutely done. I'm sick and tired of hearing this stuff. Are the ponies suffering from anything? Malnutrition, but... Huh. You know what? I want the little baby deer to actually stay inside. So let's have them in the emergency zone. Because there should be enough food in here for them to survive. But no, the pigs, they're gone. We're having pork today! And of course, we have all these rodents to kill as well. They're the ones that are eating all of our grass. So, if we can kill these, maybe we'll have a sustainable population of vegetation again. Okay, looks like you're already starting. Now, it is cold in here, right? Not cold enough. Alright, let's open up the vent. Let's see, that's... Yep, it's dropping. Perfect! Oh, this vent was a perfect idea. I mean, it only works during the winter months, but, I mean, it's still something. Really? You know you can get closer, right? You don't have to shoot from, like, a mile away. Alright, we're almost done mining all this stuff out. No. Start hauling. You two, come on. Okay. Alright, we have a lot of lembas. Stop eating the damn bread! Eat the lembas! Alright, you also need to clean this room. And clean this room. Because it's very, very dirty and we're gonna get food poisoning. Guaranteed. Look at this efficient system we have. We're drying the meats. We're cooking the lembas. Ah! It's perfect, except it's not in the ideal location because so much dirt gets tracked into the kitchens. So this system should work a little better, although I am kind of worried that they'll kind of want to cut through maybe to get to the freezer. I don't know. I don't know the best system to do this. Maybe the freezer should be above here. Just because, I don't know. We're not mining this out yet anyway, so I mean... We'll see. We'll see what happens. Why are you so mad? Night owl. Oh, you're a night owl. That makes sense. Okay. So, night owls... I'm not sure what the exact hours are for night owls, but I believe... So, we'll do something like... Something like that. It doesn't seem like a lot, but... And then 2 hours of joy. Right after you wake up and right before you go to bed. And then we'll do 5 hours of work. 2 break. And then 5 hours of work. We'll see how that works. You're going to be very, very lonely because no one else is a night owl, but... I mean, at least you'll be happy. And we are still killing all the rodents. It does take a while to actually hit these things because they're so tiny. And more keep coming in. Are you kidding me? How many more are there? Maybe we don't actually have a lot of grass. Like, this looks like it's fully grown, but I'm not too sure it is. And I'm not sure I can see that. Huh. Yeah, because there wouldn't be such a huge congregation of animals in this one area if there was food everywhere. You know what I mean? I mean, there are animals all around, but it looks like they are grouping up in certain areas. Especially over here. Are you eating the... You're eating the squirrel. Okay. I don't think I've ever seen a raccoon eat meat before, but... You know, you learn something new every day. Right, so I did want to check if I wanted to send out my caravan. And I think I do. It's not going to take that long to get there. Plus, we have a lot of Lembas. I think, yeah, we'll send Sindarian. Just Sindarian this time. I'm not going to trade or anything. I'm just going to send him out. What are you wearing? Oh, you're wearing the steel Galadrim elf armor. Perfect. That gives you a lot of protection against heat and sharp damage. Not so much blunt, but the sharp damage is really what matters. That is perfect. All right, so anyway, let's do this. Form a caravan. Sindarian right there. And we'll pick whoever this is. Okay. Choose a route all the way down there. 1.4 days. Let's give you as much Lembas as you're going to need, which is probably 10. We'll just say 10. Actually, I'd rather have you take the meat. Just because it's not... I don't know. It just seems better. All right, cool. We'll do that and accept. Oh, look at the little baby deer sleeping with one another. Oh, crap. We actually have a very, very full stockpile. And it's mostly this freaking iron. There's so much of it. We need to use it or something. Okay, so it looks like Sindarian's on his way. So he's going to get there in about 1.4 days. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Especially for the temperature outside is only 14 degrees. Which is pretty damn cold. So he's a trooper. He is definitely a trooper. I want you to butcher these animals first. But I guess that's all right. Also, cleanness and cleanness. I'm just trying to think. Where did that timber wolf go? I would like to maybe tame it. Timber wolf down there. That's the only predator on the map, like I said before. What's the 10% chance to attack? That's not as bad as the warg, so technically we could attempt the Timberwolf, and there's a better chance of us actually taming it. Who's our best handler? Probably Therian. So, Therian, attempt number two at taming a wild predator. Where are you? Why are you... Come on. Come on down. No? Why not? Gathering quartzite... No! I want you to tame the timber wolf. No usable food! God damn it. Okay, wait a minute. After you're done with this, butcher. Just butcher. There we go. Perfect. Now let's go ahead and tame the... Oh, come on. Duelander? No. Absolutely not. Are you even good? I mean, you are decent, but Therian's is way better, so we'll just stick with this. Therian... Oh, come on. What are you doing? No! Would you knock it off? Game, come on, listen to me. Thank you very much. Jesus. I don't understand how hard that was. So we finished the crafting systems. So we can actually start making some coal. I'm not sure if that's going to be cost effective for fueling things, though. Like, is it better to produce coal from wood instead of just using wood directly? I'm not too sure. So, medieval food prep artisan crafting station. A stone quarry. That's pretty cool. But we need a, what are the tools? Hand tools. How do we make hand tools? God, I really should have paid attention. We probably need a forge. And then from the forge, we make the hand tools. And then the hand tools, we can make all this stuff. I guess we could try to attempt it just to see kind of what we have to do. So if we do that right there, this is just a test. We can always uninstall these and then we'll have them for later on, but at least they'll be built. Oh my god, this is getting really, really dirty. Yeah, let's just clean up that blood. Thank you very much. All right, Therian, did you get him? Don't think so. Where'd it go? Oh, right over here. Okay. Social. Therian tried to bring the Timberwolf under control, but the Timberwolf refused. Yeah, okay, that's fine. At least he didn't attack. It's all that matters. All right, we need to figure out what to do with this stockpile, because it is incredibly full. And it looks like a lot of the blocks are causing most of the storage problems. Yeah, a lot of limestone. I mean, I guess we could keep placing pallets, but eventually the pallets are going to take more space than the actual items themselves, so it's not really ideal. But for the time being, I'll do one for limestone and one for quartzite. Okay, and that should help us organize this a little bit better. Right, so we have the blacksmith's forge. Let's take a look at what we can actually create in here. And it looks like, yep, hand tools are actually in here. So 20 steel and 15 wood for one hand tool. Seems like a lot of resources, but that's okay. We'll do it. We'll make like four. Well, our food reserves are actually looking pretty nice. We have 17 days worth of food. I mean, that should definitely help us out. Visitors have arrived. No guest beds and insects. Yeah. I will ensure your safety, but you might leave because of dangerous temperatures. We have... Oh! Dwarves! Yes! Freaking perfect! We have Durin, Melkar, Strar... Oh god, this hurts. Strarin, and Tis, or Tis. Very, very nice. Okay, so Tis is just a brawler, really. Gay, brawler, annoying voice, and industrious. Oh, sorry, she. Tis is a she. Then Strarin is actually pretty decent. Not good in mining. You're dwarves, come on. You're actually really good with your skills. So diplomat, inventor, and eagle-eyed, which is actually pretty nice. Yeah, probably gonna want you. So we'll actually go ahead and recruit. Melkar. Again, mining, come on. What the hell? None of you are good with mining. Are you kidding me? How was that even possible? A cranial nerve palsy. What? Melkar has a hard time seeing things clearly unless he... unless he what? Oh, God. Well, definitely not Melkar. Also, he's a misogynist and he's slothful, which those aren't good traits at all. So, no. Durin is decent, I guess. I think just Strorin. Oh, God. Why did I do this to myself? Why did I play a mod with names I can't pronounce? Oh, it's perfect. All right, so Strorin, you're going to be the only person we try to recruit because the rest suck. Absolutely suck. And you're not even great with mining either. But at least you're somewhat decent and you have a passion. So the reason why I care about a dwarf with mining skill is because their racial bonus actually gives them a lot of great things towards mining. Mining speed and, most importantly, mining yield. So they can actually give you more resources from mining out an ore deposit. So that's what's most important about dwarves. And these dwarves basically suck. I mean, the racial bonus is still great, because it's still applied. It's just, it's going to take them a hell of a lot longer to actually get through something, which is not good at all. So, Strorin is the only one. Let's try to get him before they leave, please. Sindirian! Who's our best social after that? Looks like Therion. Okay, so you're killing a rabbit. Wait! Yes! We have our first dwarf in the colony. Absolutely perfect. No bed, though. So let's get that set down. We need a lot more bedrooms now. And guess what? We can give him the perfect and masterwork rhinoceros leather long beard dwarf chain coat. Which is what our dwarf deserves. Look at that! Ah, that looks great. And not only that, but it gives a hell of a lot of protection. You are going to be pretty much unstoppable when it comes to melee. Of course, you're not really going to get up close and personal because you're a great shot. So, with that said, didn't we have another? I guess we can give her the crossbow. Yeah, let's do that. These are the basic ones. All right, so wardening, absolutely. Oh wait, you're a diplomat. Your social is 13. Sindarian's is, if we take a look, hang on, how do we, there we go. 13, you're actually both the same. So actually we have a diplomat to stay home and a diplomat to go on missions like Sindarian's doing right now, which is absolutely perfect. So diplomats actually give negotiation ability plus 15% and social impact plus 20%. So you're actually going to be much, much better than Sindarian because of the fact that you have that, you know, negotiation bonus. Inventor is great for research speed, not so great with work speed and move speed and mental stability, but it's pretty good. Eagle-Eyed is very, very good for shooting and I guess melee hit chance for some reason. Well, shooting accuracy is plus 5 as a base, so that's pretty good. Masochist is, it's not bad, right? Because he just likes to get hurt. I'm not sure if he's going to get a mood boost for actually getting hurt, but I guess we'll see. Right, so anyway, let's go back in here. Handling, you could be on 3, that's fine. Negotiation, 1. We could probably turn down this one. Ezgal is the night owl, so it might be better to have someone in the night that can kind of do all that stuff, but it's not really important. Cooking, you can do cooking, but I think I would rather have you not do that. You can hunt, that's fine. You can also mine, priority 1, and craft, we'll do 2. But most importantly, you can research. Maybe I'll have you on 3 for cooking as well. Yeah, that should be it. Okay, and you're already going to hunt a hare. So we'll take a look. Come on. Perfect. Cut off its head with a bolt. That's great. All right, yeah, no, the crossbow isn't as great as one of the bows, but it's better than nothing, I guess. Okay, well, I think that's going to have to be it for this episode. We didn't actually get to clean out this freaking room yet, but next episode, guaranteed, we are going to work on this dining room. Absolutely 100%. Okay? So, that'll be done next episode. Thank you all for watching, and definitely stay tuned for more.